We planted the nanobite virus in your head. Does that sound familiar? Your little girlfriend told us all about your operation. You know, Lucy and Joseph. Be ashamed if something happened to them.
What do you want?
The agenda. Where is it?
I gave it to you.
Corbin, where's the agenda?
Wait. So you're saying what I gave to you isn't the agenda?
Okay, I'm gonna count to 10. If you don't tell me where the agenda is, she dies.
Brittany, it's gonna be okay.
1.
Listen, I did what you wanted. Did you want me to do something else? Because I can do it. If there was a misunderstanding, I can handle it.
2.
Can't we just talk? Like gentlemen.
3.
What the hell is wrong with you?
Hey, wake up.
All right.
4.
All right, I'll tell you.
5.
I'm trying to tell you. Son of a bitch.
6.
All right, it's at Heritage.
I don't believe you.
Oh my God.
It's not at Heritage. 7.
I'll go and get it for you.
You think I won't put one right in her head?
Brittany, you're gonna be okay.
You think I'm playing right now?
I know
I will put one
playing.
Right in
just
her
put
skull.
Put the gun down.
8.
You don't have to do this. Brittany, we're gonna make it out of this.
8.
We're gonna be okay.
9. Tell me where the damn book is.
Locker 49. It's in locker 49.
Thank you.
10.
Hello? Yeah. The
23rd? No, what? Not the 23rd.
Shh. I gotta go, Corbin. Yeah, see ya.
Skylar,
wait.
Not for you.
What? What's wrong?
Do you realize what's on the 23rd?
No.
It's our 1-year anniversary. Like, do I even mean anything to you? You never have time for me anymore, and you're always spending time with work as a so-called private investigator.
Skylar, you mean the world to me.
Then show me.
How?
Quit. Tell Corbin you're done.
I can't quit.
Well, you're gonna have to choose, because it's either me or him.
You are freaking whipped.
Dude, come on.
You are whipped. Think about what you're giving up.
Listen.
No, you listen. Let me talk for 1 second. Every time there's a case at school, guess who solves it? We do.
Almost every time. The business with the girls' locker room, that doesn't count.
You're missing the point. Every time we solve one of the school cases, we rack up cash. And you're willing to throw that all away for a stupid girl.
If it was you and Brittany in this situation, you'd do the exact same thing.
No, I wouldn't. If Brittany tried to pull anything like that, I would dump her so fast.
Dude, I'm sorry. She means the world to me, and I don't know what I'd do if I lost her. Sorry, man.
It's whatever, man.
Alright, I think I gotta go, man.
Why?
I'm going to Peyton's party. Gotta pick up Skylar.
Dude, I heard it's gonna be crap.
Whatever. Alright, see you, man.
But it's Halloween!
Sorry, dude. Maybe next time.
Peyton's party's gonna suck!
Hey, babe.
Hey.
So what time are you picking me up tonight?
We don't have a date.
Yeah, we do. We have Brittany's birthday party.
I'm not going to that.
Why not?
Corbin's being a douche. I don't want to deal with it.
No, are you serious right now? I do so much for you, and you're just going to ditch me? You're on such thin ice right now. You realize I have other options, right? So if you think for 1 second that I can't deal without you, you're wrong.
Are you trying to threaten to dump me after I quit my job for you just because I don't go to your best friend's birthday party? Sometimes I don't even know why I date you.
No, babe, I'm sorry. Hey, what's up?
Lucy, I swear if you're here to talk about another case, I told you, I quit. I'm done. I'm retired.
What you call retired, I call taking a break. Listen, this case isn't like any of the others. It's different. Let me sit down with you. 5, 10, 45 minutes tops.
I already told you, I don't do cases without Joseph. He was into all the technical evidence stuff. I don't do that.
Screw Joseph.
No, not screw Joseph. You know, I'm starting to think he may have been right about a lot of things.
Like what?
Like, ever since freshman year, I've devoted my life to the whole private investigator thing. And I've never had time for school, friends, parties. Like, now I'm all worried about this HSE guy selling heroin. And then there's a whole nude locker room picture, whatever, all that crap. It's time to focus on more important things.
Like what?
Like, okay, so I'm a junior, which means I'm graduating in 2 years. I have no goal set for the future, and I haven't looked at a single college yet.
You sound like my educational therapist.
I'm being serious.
Okay, whatever, continue.
Okay, so I have a girl. Her name's Brittany. I haven't seen her very much lately, and today's her birthday, and I have to go to her party. I'm sorry.
Okay, call me if you change your mind.
Probably not gonna happen.
He's totally gonna call me.
Happy birthday to you.
Thanks, guys. Love you.
Love you, Bree.
Love you too, babe. That reminds me, I got you this present.
Aw, thanks. But I don't really like chocolate.
We've been dating for 2 months. You love chocolate.
I don't anymore.
Wow, I'm never going to be with you guys again. I'm calling Joseph.
Babe, we need to talk.
All right. What do you want to talk about?
I don't think we're working.
Why not?
Well, I met this guy. His name's Jackson Hart. He was the quarterback of the football team last year until he got kicked out for smoking marijuana. But, I mean, he's still an all-star quarterback.
You're dumping me for a pothead?
Yes.
First off, I recall our team really sucking last year. Second off, you can take this cupcake and shove it up your ass. I mean, it's not like I miss her that much. I mean, I didn't really like her that much, you know? She wasn't that hot, funny, smart, the most perfect girl on the planet. Like, whenever I was with her, I always had this feeling that I was caught up in a dream, you know? Like, things were too good to be true. Who knew she was a total freaking slut? Like, going off with Jackson Hart like that? And then as soon as they're done, she's gonna come crawling back to me. Yeah, but I'm done. I'm done with her.
Are you quite finished? You've been talking about this for like an hour. I'm not your freaking therapist.
You're right. You're right. Just tell me about the case.
Okay. It might sound crazy, but I'm telling you, it's the real deal.
Lucy, all of your cases are crazy. That's why I chose to do it. Get my mind off of Brittany. Because, you know, every time I start thinking about her, I start talking.
Listen. Do you want to know about this case, or are you going to continue to tell me your sob story?
Yeah, sure. Go ahead.
Thank you. What if I told you that there's a secret underground drug ring running the school? Seriously, check out the case files. Okay, so the gang's boss and leader man is Luke Weber. He literally runs the entire school. Everybody in the school's scared of him, even the administration. They all do what he says. His word is law. Next, there's the bookkeeper and the financial planner. His name is Tom Flynn. He keeps all of the gang's records in this little agenda. He lives in a condo with his brother David and his cousin Cooper. I'm not sure if they're in a gang or not, but we'll figure that out later. The last guy we can confirm is Aston Peterson. He's Luke's personal hitman. He's responsible for over 25 murders. You know all those people who got expelled or sent away from school a couple years ago?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, well, really the gang just murdered them and the school covered it up.
Yeah, see, I don't really believe that. I'm sorry.
Why?
Because you remember Spencer Woodruff?
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, his rap name, Lil SP, him and 50 Cal, which would be Cal Madoco, they are working on a new mixtape right now, so yeah. How could they be dead and working on a new mixtape?
When was the last time you heard or saw Spencer?
Just because I haven't heard from a guy in a while doesn't mean he's dead.
Shut up, Corbin, and stop being a tool.
Okay, I'm just saying that your story is not very believable.
Would it be believable if it was worth $50,000?
Maybe a little.
All right. All you have to do is find evidence that there's a gang here, but be careful. You or someone else could get killed.
Yeah, yeah.
Well, when you're held hostage and tied up and someone decides to execute your girlfriend in front of you, don't come crying to me.
I don't have a girlfriend anymore.
Yeah, whatever. You freaking schmohawk.
Excuse me, David Flynn. My name's Pat McNamara. I have a few questions for you.
Excuse me, Kelly Swan.
My name's Peter Quill. I have a few questions for you.
So you're the brother of Thomas Marie Flynn, are you not?
Who?
Your brother, Thomas Flynn. Taller, wears sunglasses a lot.
I'm sorry, I don't know who that is.
This man right here?
Oh, my brother. What a guy.
Yeah, what a guy.
Are you the current girlfriend of Luke Weber?
Ex-girlfriend, actually.
Why is that?
He said he was too busy to be in a relationship.
Too busy with what?
I don't know, he didn't say.
What kind of friends does Thomas Flynn have?
Friends? He doesn't really have any friends. I think my cousin Cooper would know more about him. His parents died, so now he lives with us. Hey, Cooper!
No friends, probably because he's a tool.
So,
this gentleman right here was asking about Thomas's friends, and guess what I told him?
What?
He doesn't have any.
That's what it does, oh, no friends.
Is it funny? Is it funny? We have reason to believe that he's a powerful drug lord.
Really? Luke? He could barely run a petting zoo, let alone a drug gang.
While you guys were dating, did you ever receive any suspicious phone calls, or was he ever taking anything?
Not that I know of. Wait, what is this for?
It's for the school newspaper.
Right. Wait, weren't you the guy who did the sophomore nude pictures case?
No.
I don't know what to do. I've been working on this case for 5 freaking days. I've gotten nowhere. I have no lead.
Hey, Katie, what's up?
I'll call you back.
Word on the street is you're working a new case.
What's it to you?
I think it's really hot.
Whatever happened to you and the big shot quarterback?
He moved to Canada.
Yeah, good for him.
Can't we just talk?
No.
Unless you have any information on Luke Weber, Aston Peterson, or Tom Flynn, or any other gang incident, I don't want to hear it. Yeah, I don't think so.
Wait, Tom Flynn? I think I know him. I hooked up with him a few weeks ago. The kid tried to sell me some drugs. But when he gets drunk, he's a big talker. He kept going on and on about this like agenda thing that he always carried with him. You know, if you want to talk to him, I saw him just a few seconds ago by the vending machines with Sabrina.
Thank you. You know, for once, you actually said something useful.
Wait, are you gonna go talk to him?
Something like that.
Well, call me.
And so Allie was like, okay.
Hey, kid.
All right, here, I'll give you this. All you gotta do is just go bump that guy over there, all right?
And she thought I was, like, I was just listening to the call.
What?
Joseph, it's Corbin. We need to talk.
Alright, boys, how's everything looking? We on schedule for this musical this weekend?
Yes, sir.
Alright, I need a tight shift for Tech Week this week. This is gonna be huge. Aston, I need you to give me some of your guys. Put them backstage. We cannot mess this up. We need to keep everything going to plan. We got, what, I think it was 50% of the school's profits coming to us. This is gonna be huge. You know how much money that is? Thomas, how are we looking on finances?
I think we're looking good.
What do you mean by think? Check the agenda.
I'm not sure where the agenda is.
What do you mean you're not sure where the agenda is? Are you telling me? You're telling me you lost.
No. But it may have been stolen.
It has everything from last year, everything that we have done, all of our finances, gone.
I know.
Are you serious? Leave. Just go.
I...
So what do you want to do?
Boss.
Cancel everything. All shipments, all deals for the month, done.
That would put us behind financially.
I don't care about the finances right now. All I care about is that agenda. You need to find out whoever took it. Check the security tapes, check everything. Whoever did it, they're done. All kill them, right. Okay?
Okay.
What is this? I hate green. Get it out of here.
I think that was Tom.
You really expect me to believe that story?
I have proof.
What's this?
The gang's agenda. Every single deal, every scandal they've been involved in is in that book.
Where'd you get this?
I borrowed it.
Oh, so you're stealing now.
It's not the point. The point is I have proof, so do you believe me?
Yeah, that doesn't mean I'm gonna help you.
Don't be such a tool.
Bro, you don't even need me. Everything you need is in this book.
But I need some technological evidence, like video recordings or voice memos. Like, this could be written by anyone.
I can't help. If Skylar even knew I was having this conversation, she'd kill me.
Dude, what is wrong with you?
Honestly, you can't let her tie you down like that, man. Like, you think I'm doing this for the money? No, I'm doing this because it's the right thing to do. These guys are doing some pretty messed up stuff, to say the least. And you're just sitting back, allowing your girlfriend to tell you what to do? I thought you were better than that.
What's up, fellas?
Hey, this is Paul. He's
it's Rick, actually. Thank
I don't care. Is he charged with sales since you fired Thomas?
Yeah, I wanted to know if you could look at this for a second.
No.
Ask him. Here you go.
All right, first off, I told you to get rid of this. I hate green, man. Yeah. Hey, like right now.
Hey, green tape. Go.
Let's go.
I mean, what's the deal? Have you dealt with this agenda thing yet?
No, not yet. We're working on it, though.
But why haven't you started?
Well, Thomas doesn't know exactly when he lost the agenda, so it's hard to check all the security tapes.
But you have one job, man. You gotta check tapes. Right. It's not that hard to find someone's face on a video.
We canceled all the plans, though. I mean, don't you think you're overreacting a little bit?
I don't think you understand what's in this agenda. We have dates. We have plans. We have finances. We have contact information. We have everything, including murders, which, do I have to remind you, you're part of most of those. We've got enough dirt on us in that agenda to put us in for 20 years.
Oh, come on, that's an over-exaggeration.
I want you to take a look around. Tell me everything you see. I'll tell you what you see. You see windows. You know what's behind those windows? Classrooms. You know who's in classrooms? Students. I wouldn't have one hesitation of putting one right through your skull in front of everyone. Bang! That's power you can't buy, kid. This is my school. I'm not gonna let someone come in here and take it from me. You have one job, find the agenda, or else it's on you. Hey, mag on me.
Hey, what the hell was that all about?
It's nothing. I want you to take over the agenda thing, all right?
Hold up. Since when is this my problem?
Seriously?
Became your problem when you got us into this situation.
All right. But I take all the credit, okay?
50%.
75.
25.
All right. 50. No questions. I'll find him, okay?
Take care of it.
Hey, I thought about what you said.
Plug this into the power source behind the stage. It'll give you access to everything electronic in the school. Security cameras, lights, anything you think.
Thanks, man. All right. That's all I can help you with. So anything else, you're on your own.
All right. Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, let me get this straight. This guy breaks into our hideout, hacks the school networking system, and I get blamed for it?
Your guys were on watch that night. It's all your fault.
Yeah, okay. One of them was in the hospital and the other was dead. You know, if Thomas didn't lose the agenda, I wouldn't be so accountable for all these mistakes.
Gosh, I'm so tired of this union worker crap. We're all in this together as a team, okay? Plus, Thomas has a plan to get him anyway.
Yeah, I bet his plan sucks. Hey, Aston.
What?
Shut up.
Hey, Thomas. What's your bartender's name?
Oh, that's this Lenny.
Hey, Lenny!
What?
Give sparkling water.
Hey, Lenny. How the hell are you? Where's my drink?
You didn't ask for a drink.
Yes, I did. A sparkling water. I just asked for it a second ago.
No. This is what you said. You said, hey, Lenny, how are you? I was like, oh, he's a real nice guy.
Why the hell would I care what you think, you dumbass? Oh. Just go give me my drink.
Alright.
Hey, Thomas. So I know you got this plan and all, but I think I might have something that would help.
Alright, what is it?
Well, okay, a couple of weeks ago, this guy came up to Cooper, and he was asking all these weird questions and all this strange crap. And, of course, we played dumb just to, you know, send him off. But the point is, if I see him again, I'm sure I could recognize the guy.
Thanks, little bro. But don't worry about it. We already know who the guy is. His name is Corbin Williamson. When he hacked into the school mainframe, he left us a little digital footprint. I already got Naboo and Cooper working on it, so he should be gone anytime soon.
Who the hell names their kid Naboo?
People from India. Duh, that's like the culture over there.
Whatever, man. Where's Lenny? Lenny! Sparkling water!
Hey, you guys look like idiots with those sunglasses.
Nah, man, it helps them not make eye contact with the targets.
You know, that's pretty gay, but you know, you're kind of homosexual yourself.
Oh yeah? Well, it takes one to know one.
You know, I don't really like you, or your brother.
Yeah, well, I think I've noticed that.
Oh, just give me a second. Hey. Alright, sounds good. That was Cooper. He already found Corbin, and he's heading his way right now.
Hey, Thomas, just a heads up. You mess this up, probably gonna kill you.
Of course he's gonna mess it up. He's Thomas.
Whoa, hold up. What's that supposed to mean?
Well, what I'm trying to say is that you're a freaking idiot and you can't do anything right.
Well, last time I checked, I'm still getting paid more than you, you stupid prick.
What's that supposed to mean?
Whoa, take it easy, man.
Hey, stay out of it. It's personal, alright?
You know, you've been a real pain in the operation lately.
I got your drink. Guys, just calm down. Everyone take a seat.
Hey, this is none of your business, dude, alright?
You got your drink.
It is now.
Hey, stranger.
Brittany, I swear to God, if you're here to talk about hooking up...
If I wanted to hook up, I already would have.
Oh, hey, all right, that's it. Who's the girl?
It doesn't matter.
I don't know, killing him and me killing his girl. I don't know how I feel about that.
Well, let's just get this done, okay?
I actually came to apologize to you. I've been kind of a jerk as of late, especially as we broke up, and I feel really bad about it. I just wish we could be friends.
Friends?
I mean, come on, what would you do without me, right?
Naboo, go over there.
Listen, Brittany, these men, they're only here for me. I can distract them for a minute, but only a minute. And you gotta get out of here. Alright? Good luck. Contacts, there's no
you bring it up. What are you doing? Kill him!
Nathan, get in there and flush your mouth. Okay, go, flush your mouth, just go. Everybody, let's get into it. Get stoned, get started, get started, get started.
Brittany!
Brittany!
Tom Flynn, how the hell are you?
Where the hell is she?
A suspect has arrived.
Where's your boss?
Hey,
hands up.
There it is.
So this is in the agenda.
One job, you have one job! Just kill someone! You didn't do that. You see the news lately? Indiana's first school shooting. You even kill anyone? You just took him hostage? I don't. Why'd you think that was a good idea? Just capture him? Now we have missing persons case on multiple homicides. You're ruining the whole friggin' operation! To be frank with you, you had your head so far up your ass lately, the lump in your throat's your nose. Now you got one more job, okay? Just give me some good news or I won't hesitate to put one right in your head.
Corbin has a team of investigators with him. Joseph Reeds and Lucy Chase. We got the information from him when we interrogated his girlfriend.
Girlfriend? What? You got a girl?
Yeah, we captured his girlfriend at the shooting.
All right, good. At least we got some leverage now. By the way, I see your guy over there. Not the best hiding place. Good try.
One more thing. The agenda Corbin gave us is fake.
Son of a bitch! Six. All right. It's at Heritage.
I don't believe you.
Oh my god.
It's not at Heritage. Heritage.
Seven.
I'll go and get it for you.
You think I won't put one right in her head?
Brittany, you're gonna be okay.
You think I'm playing right now?
I know you're
not
playing.
I will put one right in her skull.
Put the gun down.
Eight.
You don't have to do this.
Brittany. We're gonna make it out of this.
Eight.
We're gonna be okay.
Nine! Tell me where the damn book is!
Locker 49! It's in locker 49.
Thank you.
Ten.
So you're sure Brittany's body is taken care of?
Absolutely. She's at the bottom of Geist by now. And since Lake's frozen over, there's no way the cops should be able to find her. We need to start focusing our energy on that agenda, though.
Boss, we can't find it.
What do you mean you can't find it?
There's no such thing as Locker 49.
What do you mean there's no such thing as Locker 49?
Obviously, Corbin lied to you.
First off, where have you been lately?
I was in the hospital. You shot me? More importantly, what's he doing here?
I'm the new head of security. I'll be running things from now on.
David's the head of security? Suddenly, I don't feel so safe.
Listen, boy, if you got a problem with me, you better say something.
Oh, I've got a lot I'd like to say.
You better be careful what you say. You might get blood all over that shirt of yours.
Oh, what, your blood? Come at me. I'll beat the hell out of you.
Yeah, is that a threat or a promise?
Both. Just shut up, both of you.
You're acting like children.
Excuse me, Mass, I have those documents you asked for.
Oh, thank you. Thank you.
And also, this came for you.
What is it?
I have no idea.
All right.
Wait. Who the heck is she?
Hey, back down, David. She's my new bookkeeper and secretary. Promise she's not going to do anything.
Sorry, ma'am.
It's all right.
Ugh. She looked like a real killer, didn't she, David?
Shut up. I'm just trying to do my job.
Why'd you even hire her anyways?
Well, fired Thomas and remember Paul? Bang, bang. So, brought in Amy.
His name was Rick, not Paul.
Doesn't matter.
Hey, if the boss wants to call him Paul, let him call him Paul.
I'm just saying the guy died for our operation. You think you could give him a little respect? I just didn't know his name.
Would you just shut up? It doesn't matter. We need to get back to business anyway. We don't even know where this agenda is. Anyone have any suggestions?
I can call Thomas and tell him to torture Corbin.
No, there's no point in calling anyone or torturing anyone. He has no idea where the heck that book is. What he gave us, he thought was the real thing. And plus, he wouldn't have put Brittany's life on the line if he thought he knew where the book was.
Well, at least you still have the fake one?
I do still have it. Has the initials SS in it, though.
What the heck is SS?
I have no idea.
Wait, what are we even talking about?
Oh my gosh, you freaking idiot. The agenda! We still don't know where it is.
Goodness sake, turn on your brain.
We need to get rid of Corbin, though. He's being held at Thomas's house, so I'll give Thomas a call. Give him the honor of taking him out.
You sure, boss? Shouldn't we let everything die down before we kill him?
No, I'll tell you what we'll do. We gotta dress him up, give him some shoes, a nice coat, some gloves. Make it all look like a suicide. Cops will never see it coming. I think he did all the murders, too. Guilt drove him to put one right in his own head.
There's one problem with that. Thomas is doing it.
Hey, man, that's my brother you're talking about.
Your brother blows.
That does.
Whoa!
are we gonna get across?
Oh! Oh!
Well, that was painful.
Get on your knees.
Oh, well, that hurt.
Any last words?
That literally was the most cliche thing I have ever heard.
You know, you have been a real... Oh.
Thanks, Craig. I'm Tina Speckle, and I'm here live at Heritage Christian, where the school shooting took place 2 weeks ago. Three were dead, and four are missing. Despite the horrible crime that went on, Heritage Christian still refuses to shut down. Police say that Corbin Williamson is the lead suspect. He's still on the loose and very dangerous. Back to you, Craig.
Doing up here?
This is where the gang hangs out. I thought I'd come check it out.
How'd you know they hang out here?
Send the agenda.
Where'd you get the agenda?
You showed it to me, remember?
Right. Right.
What are you doing here?
Decided I'd come to the hideout and finish them off.
They're all gone. There's just a few security guards left.
Yeah. May have bumped into him on the way up here.
It doesn't make sense. Why would he waste men guarding this place when he isn't even here?
Probably to keep people like us out.
Sorry about Brittany, by the way.
How did you know about Brittany?
The news reports, I guess. I've been following them pretty closely.
Oh, okay. I got you.
Bro, what even happened?
I don't even know. I thought I gave him the real agenda, but apparently it was fake. He must have switched it out right before the shooting at the Ark.
And the thing is,
I think Luke and his gang are just as confused as I am. Like there's some middleman trying to play the entire operation for something greater. Like the gang, my investigation, everything.
Hey Lucy, it's Joseph. Just calling to let you know that Corbin is done with. It worked great. Playing the game against him worked out perfect. He never suspected a thing. We lost Brittany, but her building a fake relationship to keep him distracted was a benefit to our cause. Call up Luke. Tell him it works for us now. If he tries to pull anything, we can just turn that booklet into the police and he'll be done for. Oh, by the way, I canceled my plans with Skyla tonight, so we're back on for dinner. Alright, that's all. Love you. Bye. It started with a whisper.
It started with a whisper.